Hello, guys. Yeah, with a ball in our mouth. We can do that all day. What a fool. Let's go see the other one. We're happy to see you. We welcome you here. Buddy. A small bear. Oh, rub me behind my ear, yeah. Okay, let's go back. Okay, guys, let's take a look of what I have done in between. Let me get this over here. As you can see, I have painted the ornament. I have used pictures from the real thing. I have them right here. This is the real one, real one model. So I have used these pictures to paint the ornament, and you can see I have done a beautiful job. Pretty good. Let me tell you a secret about this job. As you see here, we have some letters. The entire piece is made in gold color, so that will that helps a lot, because I painted above the letters, all the letters in blue, and then I used a fine sandpaper and sand a little bit, and very very carefully, the above surfaces, the letters that is, to clear the paint and make them visible. Also in here, also here, what you see, also here, also here, in every single here, in every single point that I needed to have the gold surface. The crown, as you can see, has a few details of silver and black. It's already varnished. I love it. This goes bless me. This goes to the side, and I will use it much, much later, because if I do it now, probably I will destroy it. Also, an extra job that I have done, and it was very careful and very difficult, is to paint the inside of the frames red. It's exactly like the real ship. In some points, I might need to repaint a little bit, like here. You see, it's not that good, but that's minor. So today we're going to work over to the lower deck. First we're going to put on the gratings and all the stuff, then the frames. We'll see how it goes. We have a lot of work to do. Don't know if we're going to make it up to the stairs point, that is, but definitely we're going to do some work over here. So let me prepare myself, and I'll get back to you. Before we begin, let me tell you that one of the details that I will add is cannonballs, that will go definitely around here. Definitely around here also. I don't believe they're going to go over here. These are from a shotgun shell. This is the shotgun shell. Maybe you can understand the dimension. I don't know what it means, but I have kept it as a reference because I got it from a friend of mine. So this is the shotgun shell, Remington, and says here 3¾-1¼, number 6. Don't know what it means, but that's the correct size. And to test it, it's pretty easy. You have a hole here, you throw on you see here, it goes exactly, it fits, but I need my two hands to do that. So it's the correct one. Now, let me get ready, because I have to cut the pieces. I believe they're going to be painted prior to their mounting. So let me get ready and I'll get back to you. Now, before we proceed, we're going to put these two first, but let me just say a couple of things about the real Victory. The real Victory has the gratings in the natural color, like here. The surrounding is painted black. That's what we're going to do. And the cannonballs are being led in the side around the gratings in another part, another perigram with woods. So, to do that and be able to throw on the balls, I need to lift them 1 millimeter. This 1 millimeter plywood, I need to lift them another millimeter. So, on the bottom of this, perimetrically, of course, around here, and here, and also here, 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 and here, I have to glue pieces of 1 millimeter to match, of course, this size, so I can lift them up and the total will be 2 millimeters. With this way I can throw on 2 millimeter wood on the side. I believe 2x3 is going to be the correct dimension, and be able to throw on the cannonballs. So what I need to find out is 1x3, 1x4 pieces thrown here, and 2x3 for the pieces that we're going to use for the cannonballs. Let me see if I can find something in my stock. Alright. Now, let's make the big one, which is the hardest one. This is the up part, this is the lower part. So, on the lower part, I'm going to glue. This is the 2x3 that I'm going to get on the side. Now here I'm going to glue underneath some pieces. This exceeds, so I'm going to use this one. Don't care if it doesn't go all the way inside. All I care about is the outside. So this is perfect. All right, ready. Now, some sanding is required and I'll get back to you. Now, this is 2x3. 2x3. This is going to go over here, around. And this is where we're going to drill for the cannonballs. So, first of all, let me just sand this a little. Alright, 2x3, I found another 2x3. Doesn't make any difference, I'm going to paint them anyhow. So, let's see now. Let's cut two pieces for the same size. Let's glue them. The glue is dry already. It must have been absorbed by the wood. I need a steady surface, give me a moment. All right, now. Now, this one is ready to drill some holes for the cannonballs. The holes must be 2 millimeters in diameter and so one hole goes over here, one goes over here, one goes over here, and one goes over here. Now, in between, every 3 millimeters, the hole is 2 millimeter, so every count 3 with a space around the hole, so every 5, yeah, every 5 millimeters we do a hole. No, every 5, wrong. Three millimeters apart. Yeah, 3 millimeters apart. It's 2 millimeter the hole, so it goes around here. Yeah. No, I don't like it. Every 4 millimeters apart. Every four, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. 28, 28. Okay, that one came a little bit close. Let's do them every 3 millimeters apart. Let's see. Multiply by 3, ends up at 34. At 33, yeah. So every 3. 3, 6. 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30. Okay, let me do them all and I'll get back to you. All right, got them both. Now, here I used a different type of wood because the other one didn't have any more of the other one, but doesn't matter because I'm going to paint them. So, same thing as here. Before drilling any holes, I must mark each hole so the drill doesn't walk around the wood and hit the hole precisely. To do that, I'm using this pin. Now, let me do them all and I'll get back to you. Drill. All right, now 2 millimeter drill tip, and we're going to do a hole, but not all the way through. Like that. Let me do another one. Like that. Not all the way through, just like that. Now, here there's supposed to be, so, sorry, give me a moment. Here there's supposed to be a ladder of some kind, and going to the lower decks, but there isn't one, and of course there's not a simulated one. So let me see something. This is going to be placed like that. All right, so let's say that the ladder goes here. So from here, here we're not going to place any cannonballs because it's supposed to be a ladder. Same thing over here. Don't put any cannonballs at this point. Even though I have made a bigger frame, don't put any ladders over here. So let me drill the holes and I'll get back to you. Got them. Now I have to paint black the outside, only this black, and I'll get back to you. Maybe up to the gratings, I will see. Painted, they're beautiful. Now let's throw on the cannonballs. Now you get the idea. Let me do them all because this will take a lot of time, and I'll get back to you. Cut them. Painted, varnished, dried, completed. Now I have to put them on. I will do that out of the camera because I have to be able to align them, and I'll get back to you to continue.
got them perfectly aligned. Now, let me see what we need to do next and I'll get back to you. We need many parts. So, let me file them, cut them, because they're going to be painted black. And I believe all of them. And I'll get back to you to continue. Here are all the parts that we're going to need. Also some 1mm wire. Now, definitely I have to clean them. Also paint them black, that is. And I'll get back to you to start mounting them. Alright, now, let's begin the assembly. I do believe that something is wrong, something doesn't add up. Anyway, we will find out. Have a lot of things to assemble. Don't know if these are going to be lined up correctly. These are going over there. Of course, some repainting is in order to correct some minor flaws. I don't like much the result here with the cannonballs, so on the top we're going to do things a little bit different, but okay, everything here is going to be covered a lot, so there's going to be a little sight of what you see here. Now, little things are going to be visible. I do have the feeling that this must be a lot shorter. We will see. Now, we have to throw on first the piece over there. So we need 1.8 by 2. This is okay. This is the piece. Let me find something out. So, I was on piece shorter. I haven't cut this one, but okay. Now, the one piece goes over here. There are gaps. You cannot put it in the wrong way. Now, this piece has guides, has two holes. Hopefully, they are visible.
course we need to glue it. Now, continue with a frame. This goes like that on top. It fits perfectly. This goes over here like that. So let me glue that because I have to follow the curve and maintain the same height as you see here, and I'll get back to you. Got it. Now I'm going to glue this piece that goes above. As you can see, I have positioned it. And now I'm going to glue it. Okay. I see here, let me check something. Now let me show you something. Here we're going to throw on, first of all, I made this 1 centimeter shorter. The manual says 2.5, I made it 1.5 because these are pillars to tie some ropes around to perform as the end of the ladder. Here there should be a ladder going down. Anyway, these are going like that. If you press them a little bit, they will fit in position like that, and it's a perfect match. Underneath each of these pieces there's going to be two pillars holding them in position. Here I unglue the piece. That's not a problem. I can glue it back again. Maybe I need to do some filing on the side. Perfect match. What I suggest to do is do not glue them in position at the moment, because they are too close to each other. As you can see, another goes here. This is the situation when finished, of course. They are too close to each other. And when the time comes to throw cannons underneath, there's going to be a big problem. There's no way you can work underneath here and throw the cannons on. So what I'm suggesting is put them, fix the pillars,
don't glue them, because if you glue them, you won't be able to throw the cannons. What I'm going to do is fix my position right underneath of each one the corresponding number, starting from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and put them on the side. So after I throw all the cannons, tie everything, then I will just place them in position and glue them. I believe that's the correct thing to do. If you wish, do it like the manual says. If you don't, follow my advice. So let me fix them in position, write the numbers, and start making the pillars that will go underneath. So this will take some time. I'll get back to you. Before making the pillars, let's finish the rest of the pieces. These are going, you see, here we have a couple of gaps, but on the other side there are none. These are going like that between the pillars over here. So let's glue them. And we still have two pieces. There are guidance, there are some holes down here that these pieces will fit in, exactly like the previous ones. Here we have another piece that will fit over here like that. I just have to center them. That's not a hard job, and I also have to paint that. So I will do that, and after I place them, I'll get back to you to throw on the pillars for the vertical bars. Now, to see how much I need, I placed one of the vertical ones. I put the piece over here, as you can see. I marked the top, and the top is here. I took these two pieces, put them to the side, and found out that I need that much, and that much is 1.5, so I need 12 1.5 pieces. Let me cut them and I'll get back to you. Now, these are the pillars. I have cut two more. I've seen that the third vertical piece doesn't have any pillars, so I need 20 of them. I need 20 of these small ones, and I need 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 pillars. Not an easy task, but not very hard to also. This is the way. Let me do them all. And done. Glued this piece, also painted. Glue the pillars. I have the rest over here. Underneath each one. Let me focus. You can see right 5, left 5. Left this side, right this side. So I know which pillar goes where. I will place them, of course, after I place the cannons. I don't want to get my life to make it harder than it is. And this concludes our today's video. We've done everything here except from the ladder. The ladder will be done in our next session. And as I can see, this has been done. We'll move directly to the bow and, of course, to the main deck. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Things ability. Also, take your time and check out the Modern Central recommendations that I have made for you. You might find something that interests you. Thank you very much again. Take care. See you soon.